Hi, welcome to the Public Observatory here at the National Air and Space Museum. My name is David DeVorkin. I'm Curator of Astronomy, and I want to give you a little introduction to this new facility that we have. You know, 2009 was the 400th anniversary of the application of the telescope to astronomy. And we celebrated that with the International Year of Astronomy, a program that was sanctioned by the United Nations. And one of the mottos, or one of the challenges of that year, was to have as many people on Earth look through a telescope and look at the night sky and look at the beautiful things in the sky as possible. So what the National Air and Space Museum and the Smithsonian decided to do was to put a telescope where the people are. And of course, this is a very popular museum, and everybody comes to the mall for all sorts of reasons. And what we sort of wanted to do is give them a chance to run through a professional telescope that's actually looking at something, so they can look for themselves and see the sky, both during the day and at night. We look at the sun, we look at the moon, we look at planets during the day, and then at night, although we're not open too much, we see stars, galaxies, all of that sort of good thing. Now, this telescope originally came from Harvard, and we identified it. It was a telescope that was built in the 1960s for professional instruction for Harvard graduate students, and they weren't using it anymore, so they lent it to us, and we worked with the National Science Foundation to be able to build the observatory around it and to put it on the east terrace of the museum here. We're open on clear days throughout the week and throughout the year, and so far we've entertained over 50,000 people to get a chance to come in and look at the sun, the moon, the planets through the various telescopes we have. So what I want you to do now, I want to invite you to come on into the observatory and meet the staff and get an idea of what it's like to be in a real professional observatory here at the National Air and Space Museum.
Hi, I'm Katie Moore. I'm an astronomy educator here at the observatory, and I'm going to tell you a little bit about our three telescopes. We have the Finder scope and another telescope that we usually use to look at the sun, and I'll let you know a little bit more about the observatory's main telescope, which is a Boller Chivens. The observatory's main telescope is a 16-inch Boller Chivens telescope. It's this one right here. And it's a reflecting telescope. That means it has mirrors inside. We use it to look at the planets during the daytime, usually Venus. And we can also take pictures of Venus to show how its phases change from week to week over time. We had an articulated eyepiece specially made for the telescope so that visitors of all heights can reach the eyepiece and see what we're looking at through the telescope.
My name is Shelley Witte. I'm an astronomy educator here at the observatory. In addition to the planets that we can look at in the daytime in the observatory, we also can look at the sun safely. And this contraption right here is called the sun gun. It was donated to us by Bruce Hegerberg, who is an amateur astronomer down in Georgia. And to look at the sun this way, we have the Finder scope, which is attached to the main telescope. The sunlight comes through, and we can project it onto the screen right here. And this lets us look at the surface of the sun. So one solar feature that you can see are sunspots. And visitors are always surprised to see those, to learn how big they are and what exactly sunspots are. In addition to the sun gun, we can also look at the sun's solar atmosphere, the chromosphere, and that we can look at it through our portable telescope that we have outside. And you can look at different features that are on the sun, including prominences and filaments and other really cool features. So we also have a school program set up where kids can come in and they can look at the sun through three different telescopes and learn about the different features that they can see through each one.
Hi, my name is Erin Braswell. I'm also an astronomy educator here at the observatory. So in addition to people being able to walk right in and look through the eyepiece and look at the things in the sky, we also try to take images so people who can't come in to walk through our doors can look at them online. So we take images of all the different planets. We've taken pictures of Jupiter at night, also Venus in the daytime. Way back in July, we started taking images of Venus, and we've been able to track how Venus changes shape, changes phase over time. So on days when it's really clear and nice, and the sun is doing something really interesting, we can hook up this camera, which also serves as a webcam, and we can let people all around the world tune in and see what's going on in the sun right at this very moment through our sun telescopes.
Thank you for listening to this edition of Ask an Expert. A companion question and answer session for this lecture may also be available. For a schedule of upcoming Ask an Expert lectures at the museum, please visit www.nasm.si.edu.